Damn, okay, we hot. We hot. Oh, we up and rolling. Okay. Welcome back to another episode of The Trenches. Excuse me. The weather's changing. You know, everybody in my house is sick. I'm the only one that dipped it, but I feel like I'm losing my voice. It's crazy, bro. I was like, before the game, I felt like I was losing my voice. I told D-Lena, I said, this shit my bread and butter. All I do is talk.
Oh, man, you got to get a call.
Imagine, I'm going to
take a hall,
nigga. If I can't
speak,
that's right. That's a real injury. I'm going to have to go out.
Got to get away for not talking.
I'm saying, I'm in a locker room.
I'm
going
to push the fuck out of the calls, nigga. Do not ask me. I
can't. Speak what?
One why, nigga. One why, nigga.
Speak with the what? With this, Joe, the two hands.
Not the hands. You know, you be getting a little sassy.
Oh, my God.
It's getting crazy. But, yes, welcome to another episode of The Trenches. Peace and blessings. You know what I'm saying? Look, man. Look, we in it. We in the run. We in the crunch, man. We in adversity, as Shane said. You know what I mean? Know it's going to come. It affects everybody. Just got to stay faithful. Got to stay in it. You know what I'm saying? But always to my right, NFL star.
EJ Spears. The kid that did.
I'm not going to lie, Speed. I missed you last pod. I know you had to go take care of some other
things. Yeah.
I miss y'all too, man. Y'all.
Yeah, man.
Even though I see this nigga all day, every day. I know this nigga
Jayda was capping on that motherfucker. I wish y'all had Jayda.
Okay, first of all, we definitely
was letting Jayda get off with way too much. I feel like that was right. I'm listening.
The McDonald's niggas is in full
first
effect.
First of all,
right?
Okay, no.
Bro.
Look,
like, what?
See, bro. I like McDonald's french fries. I'd rather you take me to get some french fries that I like than go to fucking dinner.
Jayda, you not going to no McDonald's. Can we just stop? Like,
McDonald's french fries is
starting off bad already. Like, don't double down on the double down.
Yes, bro. Please cut the cap.
getting crazy. Speed, how you feeling, bro?
I'm good, man. We on a losing streak right now, but shit.
Okay, put a light on it.
Hey, only two games behind. Yeah, it's still early. Niggas better not sleep. I know that.
Okay.
Niggas better not sleep.
One and oh. Look, we still feeling it. Look, man, we coming home Mondays. That shit still stinging like a sting. Shit, we are, though. To my left, always, I got his back. He got my front. My brother Tim, what's up? Hey, new NapTown native.
Hey, man, I appreciate y'all. NapTown.
Ready to take
y'all,
over.
Obviously, I mean, you know, and I told Jayda, I apologize. I'm sorry. But, you know, my introduction to Indianapolis was also to an introduction into a new year. My birthday was a couple days ago.
Yes, sir.
You know, man, it was a blessing, you know.
How was your birthday?
Bro, great time, man. You know, I got a chance to, you know, touch the city a little bit, do a little moving around, a little shaking. I'm not going to lie to you. I told somebody a little earlier, man, it was just good, like, you know, seeing all the people in one place just partying. Mm-hmm. And you wouldn't worry about no others. You was just, yo, I'm here. I'm cooling. Mm-hmm. So it was good. Grab me a drink or whatever. Chill
sure,
on my birthday.
For sure.
I'm with the guys.
That was the day you was moving, right?
Yeah.
A lot of traveling stuff.
Yeah.
He actually pulled up with me to the Hangtime Philly. First of all, shout out to Hangtime.
For sure.
Shout out to Monty out there. You actually been there. That's John right off of 38th.
Yeah, you know
exactly what I'm talking about. We've been there a couple times.
They got the Dickie suits in them drinks.
Yeah, they got all the drinks. Mm-hmm.
But I think I got the little vintage Colts hoodie.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we had the little Hangtime shoot. Shout out to my young boy, Josh Down. Shout out to Young Drew Far East.
Yeah.
Don't give me in nothing, though. I be turning the young boys up so much. I say, a couple of y'all niggas really from Indianapolis. I can't really be in the gang affiliate.
really trench work, like.
Yeah,
real
nah,
time.
No, yeah, so on Tim's birthday, he pulled up to the shoot, though. Then we pulled up and got the steak.
Yeah. Oh, hops, man. Come on. That Johnny, hey, I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. This time, it was better. Light on the mustard.
I still ain't pulled up. I gotta pull up.
Actually, the crazy thing happened. So I left him, and then I went, then my car broke down, bro.
Oh, shit, yeah.
On the road, my car broke down. Yeah. It really, honestly, I've been telling, it's funny because I literally tell Speed probably like every other week, I'm like, yo, Speed, I'm going to need to borrow one of your car. I got to put my joint. Every other week, I literally had just told him this joint like that day before, like, yo, Speed, this the weekend. Speed know I be bullshitting. He all right, bro.
Talk about this the weekend.
Yeah. he don't even look up. He just all right, bro. My joint's tied. I got a wheel lock, all kind of crazy. Long story short, we went for the AAA. I'm like, damn, it's a high school game across the street.
Uh-oh.
I pull up to the game. First off, I'm standing at the gas station. I see two parents. they filling up, they joined with air. I'm like, damn, it's a high school game across the street. They like, oh yeah, it's the playoffs. I said, oh, it's the playoffs?
Ooh, juicy.
Gotta go check it out.
I said, oh, what's going on? They saying sectionals. I said, okay, that means it's good on good out here, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so I pull up over to the little joint. First of all, we pull up. I mean, we in Candy joint. Candy got the all black slate, so
yeah.
We pull up in that joint. The mom at the ticket joint talk about something. Who pulled up? The Obamas?
I'm Yo, dead.
Wait, hold on. Hell wait,
no.
I'm funny. I'm like, no, now she grinding me up like that, though.
Hold on. She was low-key throwing shade. Like,
I know, like.
Yo, she thought y'all was coming through a motorcade.
Yo. That's
crazy. Look, then we pull up. But long story short, we pull up to the joint. Vibes out that joint. Yo, okay. Young boy at quarterback. Crib that shit. 3 times in the first quarter. I said, oh, yeah, young boy.
Whoa. What do you know? That you remember the name of the school?
Yeah, it's called Park Tudor or some shit. I was telling
Park
Speed,
Tudor.
Bro, I was telling Speed, like, it's so weird when you move to another city how weird they high school names be.
Swear,
because like, what is that?
That's a peak. What?
I'm not gonna lie to you. Indy got a high school called Raceway High School.
Like, what? That sounds like a gas station.
That joint, I've never heard of a high school though being called like Raceway High School.
Like, well, sound, you know, like, it probably makes sense in
Indy
though.
Yeah, Indy is a speed. Nah. He knew.
That's what I'm saying. I'm new here, guys. Nah, come on. Okay,
all right, but also checking in always, Miss Maddie. First of all, fresh off the camera, we let you get away with a lot, but we always love you. Hey, Miss Jayda.
Later.
How you doing today?
Not that I let me get away with a lot. I don't know. I'm great. How are you guys?
Blessed, man. Blessed to be in here. So, obviously, we got a lot to recap, a lot to get into.
Come
on. Got to start with the Browns. Excuse me? Boy.
Let me sit up.
I'm going to be honest. Like,
you ready?
And Speed will tell you this.
Okay.
I've been telling Speed about the Browns since, like, week two. It's too much familiarity. It's too much familiarity. First of all.
I did get that.
Shout out A-Walk.
Okay.
Shout out Rob McLeod. Shout out Matt.
Okay.
Shout out the gang. Shout out.
Shout out Bubba. Shout out my guy.
Shout out Bubba.
Shout out Bubba. Shout out Bubba. Bubba the guy.
Shout out Bubba.
Wait. Not Speed trying to be cool during the game. Speed.
Bro, you was hollering at him during the game, bro.
Look, Speed. Bro. Look.
Yo. How you even make it over there? They on defense.
Me and Bubba made eye contact, dog.
Hold on.
And knowing me and Bubba history, you feel what I'm saying?
No,
I got on with Bubba. No, you feel what I'm saying?
Okay. It wasn't just Bubba. It was like 3 different people. But then I'm like, yo, Speed, you can't dap up 3 different niggas. Come on,
come
Speed.
On, bro.
Speed, come on.
You got to keep it gangster.
The third dap up is when I, because you know I got to get him in beef. You can't be cool with niggas. We can't
That's
do that.
A fact.
You feel me?
Not friends.
That's a fact. No, we got to... Dang, so you
I was disappointed in myself when he called me. That's me.
The third one was too far. Two, I can understand.
Hold on, this was mid-game? Like,
yeah.
Nah, it wasn't mid-game. Like, wasn't shit going on. I think somebody, we had an injury on the field or something like that.
Okay.
And it was one of our guys, so I had to be there. You feel what I'm saying?
Okay.
And then in the midst of it,
niggas was like, hey, Speed. Pause. You used that opportunity to...
Yeah, no,
you
I didn't. I was with my guy.
Hold on,
I was with my guy. That's but it's a point in an injury. It's a point during the injury where you go check on your mans and da da da, and then you let the medical team take over.
Right.
Get
right,
out of the way.
Right,
don't be that nigga that's all in the way and shit.
For no reason. Yeah, that's a fact.
So during that time, the Browns took it upon themselves to say, what's up, Speed? And I turn around, I dap niggas up, and
these
then I turn around
and
niggas
talk about something. I'm Speed. On the floor.
I like, bro. You right, nigga. You right. Let me get back focus.
Hey, yo. Speak on the kumbaya that happened in the mid. Like, especially like they challenging the play. Think about it. Y'all at home watching. It's 15 minutes commercial.
Facts.
Oh, yeah. We just standing out here. Like, hey, we ain't got nothing else to do. We out here waiting for
the okay, y'all. We got to give you a little slack because it was low-key like a little Colts reunion, though.
No, it was. Real. It was. It was real. Sure. And this is back to what I always say. I hate playing my friends. Like, I'm out there trying to. I'm messing with A-Walk and shit.
A-Walk
though. He on that with us. A-Walk take off.
Hey, A-Walk,
know we love him, bro. We know we love you, A-Walk.
For sure.
Come on, man. You know
for sure. Back to the 2K days, man.
Come on, man.
Back to the 2K days, man.
Linebacker dinner used to be treacherous.
For sure.
It was gang.
It was really gang. But, hey, look, respectfully, though, I mean, not to go too crazy, you know, I'm going to let y'all know that hanging with them, bro, like that unit was definitely an event, bro.
Oh,
like, that was always a good time, bro. That was really a good time.
Bro,
I remember Speed used to be on the pool table. He got with me. I take my slug. I lost the Speed.
Not only you.
Oh my God.
That's how you gonna act?
I'm just saying.
That's how you gonna act.
I'm just saying, bro. I'm Speed. That guy when it comes to that.
Yeah, no, we gonna run it back though.
I ain't gonna let you.
You gonna run it back?
Hey, look, he got all. I'm new to the. You know what I mean?
New to the. Yeah.
Yeah, all yeah, right. He's right. Hey, he be trying to pop his.
Niggas wasn't at the Boys and Girls Club. That's where you get good at right now.
Okay. But that was that. Like I said, no real talk though. Like it was good actually. You know, it was like obviously where you guys came from, seeing y'all talk about it, and then you know the combination of it being a picture on IG and everybody there.
I gotta be honest.
Yeah.
And I know people gonna be mad about this. That shit started off as a linebacker picture. Let me start. let me explain how it went though. So it started damn. Me, Speed, D-Lena, we hollering at A-Wall, Matt, pull up. You know, everybody kind of chopping up, right?
Okay.
But then we like, damn, let's take a picture. Yeah. So we about to get a picture of linebackers. Kenny jumping. Now, let me say this. Kenny is a linebacker. Kenny is a linebacker. He fit the run like he runner and a striker. He went through all that shit with us. And Kenny used to pull up the linebacker dinner all the time. He was in the linebacker group chat. Kenny a linebacker.
Okay.
So like Kenny, all right, Kenny in the pick. Cool. I bet. Rod McLeod jump in the pick. I love Rod.
Love Rod.
Shout out to Erica. Like
squad.
I love the game.
Right.
Rod jump in the pick now though. Then PJ, then PJ Walker jump in the pick.
Oh.
Then it's just, all right, now
DT
it's
DT jumping. Yeah. Like,
now it's gangster.
Now it's a Colts pick. It's like,
now it's a Colts pick. Everybody get in.
No, for sure.
Oh, trainers. It's still a good picture, though.
It's still a good picture. We love everybody.
If you ain't do $3 a night, nigga.
Yeah, man. Look. It was cool when everybody used to just laugh. Oh, linebackers had a practice. Yeah, nigga. We out here dying.
Oh, man. You're getting right. Getting crazy.
Shit used to be a team meeting joke. Nigga, this ain't no joke, nigga.
We out here getting it.
We about to go out there and do this shit. It's 2 hours, nigga.
No, that's crazy.
Yeah, a lot of dog days with the guys, man. I ain't gonna lie, it was a crazy feeling. And Matt hit us afterwards, man. Shout out Matt, man. I got that boy jersey. He's coming up on the wall soon. But it was just like crazy just to kind of see everybody just doing their thing, man. Mm-hmm. That shit just it's kind of crazy because it's like in the moment we kind of sat back and we all understood that about each other. We all know, like, damn, he nice. He actually woo de woo. On another team, he probably would. And then to see that come to fruition.
You know what I mean? You got a player. Now it's like, yeah.
You see him walk out there. You see him Matt out there cooking. Obviously, always checking out Bobby O. Shout out Bobby O.
Bobby.
Just like, and then to see the guys. And then shit, we over here now.
Right.
Let's not do that. But you know what I'm saying? So it's always crazy just to see everybody doing their thing, man. That's just what turned it up, man. But yeah, it was a lot of familiarity.
For sure.
I guess we can't even talk about the Browns without. Right. Discussing fucking Myles Garrett in my opinion. Like,
bro.
Let me just say this. I've seen people have jumped over the line before. That's, I ain't gonna say it's not a rare play. It is a rare play because there's only a handful of people in the league that could actually complete some shit like that for sure. But I would just say it is a rare play that's happened. Like, people do it. You know, somebody got, you know what I mean? You scouted out, woo de woo de woo. However, I've never seen a nigga from a 3-point stance. Jump over two people. This nigga landed on one foot. No, understand that. First of all, he landed on one leg. Immediately touched the ground. That's
in the L.
That's a rep, gang.
In the L.
You know they tested his ass. Y'all ever seen the bottom?
Everything in my shit a crack.
Right, you a broom.
Bro, that's some abnormal shit, bro.
Have y'all seen a viral video of him doing a box jumps on like ESPN or whatever?
I never believe that shit. I be hating all
of it.
I was at that workout.
Damn.
We was working out together. That shit started as everybody doing competition.
Mm. He just started wild.
Nigga went like two levels above what the fuck I did.
God damn.
Who the craziest?
By the time he was doing that shit, I was like, I'm about to go finish my workout, y'all.
Who the craziest athlete that you done seen like on some workout shit? Like when y'all was working out together, you like, oh yeah, this nigga in here, like he doing some other shit.
Myles Garrett. On the track, that nigga Cisco from Jacksonville.
Cisco, shout out to Young Cisco.
On the track.
Shout out to Young Cisco. Cisco fast like that?
That nigga be floating on that track, boy.
Damn.
He got track speed?
Yeah.
I feel like I just never seen it's Cisco. So I know he fast and quick and shit. Shout out Cisco. Yeah. I just never seen him run, but like I never trained with him too. That training should be different.
Damn.
I ain't gonna hold you.
Daddy Mills was a fool on the track too. That nigga can run.
I ain't gonna hold you. I trained with that nigga DK Metcalf one time, bro. Well, a couple times. Shout out to DK. Yeah. He crazy though. But that nigga trained like it's something wrong with him, bro. Like y'all see when he be flipping out like every 5 games and he just do some wild shit. He act like that in the weight room. This motherfucker doing ass. I'm out.
Oh, hell no. Want some other shit.
You gotta be intense, bro.
Shout out to you. Bro, this motherfucker threw the medicine. I'm like, oh, yeah, this motherfucker.
Hey, what the fuck?
He got some shit going on. But no, I ain't gonna hold you. No, yeah. Myles Garrett was out there tripping. He was out there tripping. He, I ain't gonna hold you. That nigga, that's some game record shit. I mean, shout out to him. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
I feel like we all, like, you know, as defenders, we want to be a great player. You want to change the game and shit like that. But just you putting points on the board, taking points off, you going crazy. It's only a handful of people in the league that could probably on a couple fingers now. I ain't going to hold you. Who you like, Miles or TJ Watt?
Miles.
Why?
This nigga's a wrecking, bro. Like, bro, okay. Just too athletic. I think Miles can drop in coverage.
He drops in coverage? Yeah, I thought y'all seen it, yeah.
I'm confident that he can drop in coverage.
Oh, yeah. Is he capable for sure?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I don't know if TJ Watt can drop in coverage like that.
You said you don't know if TJ
Watt. I don't know if he can. Not saying he can.
You know TJ Watt picks six some shit like probably every 3 weeks.
For real?
Yeah, he be doing shit like that.
Shit.
This nigga dropped to the bus and robbed a curl.
God damn.
And cribbed it from the other side, though.
Yeah, I ain't even did that yet.
And he'd be like 28.
Yeah.
This is slick, hella random. But, okay, like, how is it, you know, when y'all have former coaches that come back, like, somebody like Bubba, like, Bubba's smart as fuck. And, like, be coming up with some random shit, be, like, just be, oh, they gonna do this on it. Like, how is that, like, on the other side? And you like, oh, shit.
That shit low-key a battle, because, like, you know what you fucked up on when he was here. So you thinking like, maybe this nigga trying to expose.
He about to expose that.
Yeah, yes, he sir. Trying to expose what the fuck he know you fucked up on.
Yes, sir. It's the game.
Crazy part, Bubba taught us all that we know about special teams. As a matter of fact, so like,
Yeah.
When he came back, nigga was high alert. Like, hold on, nigga.
Hell yeah.
What you got for us?
It's crazy because I feel like that happened so much. I mean, even when we eventually get into the Saints game, it's crazy because it's like, when you on the same team as somebody, and I always think this great, like, you eventually can end up competing against them. So, like, Derek Carr was in Vegas with, you know, our coordinator and stuff like that. So it was, like, familiarity on both sides. Like, you get what I'm saying? It's like, that should be the game within the game. You get what I'm saying? Right. So it's like, damn, like, you know what I mean? Bubba taught us and coached us and worked with all the shit that, you know what I mean, we struggle with. And then, you know, he be like, damn, you know, motherfucker, I do remember you struggled on that three-way. You damn.
Yeah.
Hit me like,
I'm still, still having issues with that motherfucker.
That's what you want. Like, you really supposed to help me with that, John. But all right, don't worry about it. Now you trying to hit me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I always be feeling like how weird that is, too, especially, like, for the coaches. Because I feel like, you know what I mean, you could be, officer coordinator and defensive coordinator. And then next thing you know, y'all head coaches against each other and different shit like that. But then I feel like, you know, that's where, like, you know, when I study the game, I ain't gonna lie, I'm like a little bit of a football nerd, but like, I love seeing like where head coaches came from, what staff they was under, like who they, you know, they kind of got their scheme from, where they start, or they was a part of this, they was part of that. It'll teach you a lot about like, you know, teams like call philosophy, like, you know, kind of different scars they had, different success they had, how they played when they had certain personnel and stuff like that too, so. But yeah, I'm like literally a nerd. Like I told Speed, sometimes I can't even move until I watch the game on Sundays. Like,
nope.
For sure. I mean, obviously both of y'all being in the profession, like I think that's a part of it. It sounds like hunger. You know what I'm saying? I still want to be great.
I love history to an extent. So I feel like because I love football, I feel like history just could tell you so much about like, you know what I'm saying?
No,
what's
facts.
The come,
yeah.
What's going
no,
on?
Yeah.
Like, you
yeah.
know what I'm saying? Yeah. I feel like it just gives you such a fresh perspective on what's going on. To let you know that pretty much everything that's happening ain't new.
Yeah.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Thanks. Somebody then, what they said, you're only facing what other men have met. So, but I'm going to leave that alone. But yeah, fast forward to the game. What you remember about the Browns game? Oh, wow.
I remember something.
Hey.
First of all,
I be feeling like the when I.
Bro, so.
Ooh.
So this nigga Matt, bro.
Why well, I gotta Matt. Start like that?
First of all, we run out the tunnel.
Okay.
Matt damn near on the field.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I immediately get on that with him. Like,
oh.
Like, nigga, you got like fucked up. You ain't no savage, nigga.
Oh.
You ain't no savage. I know I'm looking at a savage, but nigga, not today. Like, you ain't no savage, nigga. Woo, woo, woo. Get to the sideline. Now he got me hot. You feel what I'm saying? Let me get ready. We go to kickoff. I'm at the 3. Matt blocking the 4. Run down. He, nigga, get at the 4. Whoop, 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 whoop.
Wow.
I mean, you ain't said nothing but a word.
Ooh.
Next, I go to the special team coach. Hey, I'm going to the 4.
Okay.
Fuck it, let's go.
Make the call.
I go to the 4. Tell me why Matt blocking somebody else now. I said,
you wanted the one-on-one, bro.
I said, you wait till I tell the fellas. I said, you wait till
Matt
I tell
the
fellas.
Matt ain't dug in no red.
Matt did.
Ain't nobody dug in no red.
He really lied to you,
though. He talking about some, nah, bro, we switched the return. So now I'm in double teams with some other motherfuckers. He probably did lie to
me. Yeah, he lied to you. Yeah, he probably told Bubba, I give him the switch.
You know, I'm loose crew out there. You know, I'm loose crew. He probably go to Bubba. Bubba, I got his ass.
I'm crashing out. I'm trying to crash. You know,
that's Matt bag. You know, Bubba, I got his ass. I put him in the double team.
That's crazy. Bro. That's crazy, man.
Yeah, but I thought you was going to bring up the fumble.
The fumble? Bro, I needed that.
That's what I thought you was going
to
bring up.
Ain't it like, is it against the rules for us to talk? I think it's like against the rules or some shit like that.
Well, damn. I don't know. This shit came
I'm already under like 3 fines right now, bro. I ain't going to hold you.
I got to stop fucking with speed. Because being around your ass, fined and shit. I'd have been warned and shit. Like, nah,
I'm
like you look,
I'm going to hit y'all with the fines, bro.
The refs ain't been fucking with us ever, bro. I'm sorry, bro. Like, y'all ain't got no jobs.
They watched that pod. Someone from me.
They mad because they said y'all got, they got real jobs and that shit is part time.
See, that's fucked up.
I'm saying we don't get no hometown calls. Yeah, like, all right. Our 50-50 shit go the other way. Yeah. I'm like, damn. We got
like you know you live in Carmel. Come
we got
on,
like
give
three, four
call.
Turnovers. I stopped running to the end zone at this point. I'm like, man, I'm waiting on these niggas fucking around.
That shit break your heart. You hustled all the way down there celebrating.
Taking a picture and shit.
Gang, gang.
Take your picture, called that shit.
Now you got to turn around.
After further review, oh, my God.
You're lame.
And I'm going to tell you the saltiest part is, like, we be knowing beforehand.
Oh,
so like
absolutely.
they get the call from up top to the head coach. The head coach, offense out. You know what I mean? Shit like that. So you be out and then you be like, no, defense still up. You could tell when niggas get the shuffling. Like they get the new circumstance. No, we gonna go. No, what personnel? Wow. Why you even? Let me go ahead and walk my sad ass back on the John.
Let me get this call.
Done talking. Oh, shit, run it down.
So I go, I get the strip sack, bro.
Okay.
I get the strip sack. On my way down from getting the strip sack, I feel PJ trying to get up and like chase the ball. So like I'm turning to like grab this nigga leg on some like Craig and Pinky in the goddamn stove. Nigga said, I'm going to go grab this nigga leg. And I see the ref throwing a flag like on some like, I'm trying to grab his leg. I see the ref throwing a flag. And how our luck been going, I just knew it was some bullshit. So I get up, D. Leonard, he come over there. And by the way, I got a TFL. This nigga D. Leonard knocked the wind out of me, nigga. Oh, you man. See that picture with me, you and him?
Oh, yeah,
bro,
yeah, yeah.
Leonard, I said, tell that nigga punch me hard as bitch.
Hold up. I told Speed on Friday. I said, Speed, me and you got to get a handshake because I feel like when you make a play, I just beat the shit out you.
Both these niggas, bro, because y'all know I don't be celebrating. Y'all just come over there and just...
Y'all be trying to push him into the camera.
Punching the niggas.
Hit you in the head. Hit you in the toe.
Fight these niggas.
I told you, when you make a big play and then you head it to the sideline and you just got to walk through the seat, people, everybody just smacking
the shit out of
you. Everybody getting that you are after like the fuck you...
Even one of them now. Stop smacking now.
Stop playing on me, bro.
Hey, you ever accidentally made a play on some shit? But like, it was a good play, but it was an accident. And you get to the sideline, and niggas like showing you hella love. But
you whole like, time your ass
you feeling like weird. You feeling
guilty
gross.
And shit. Guilty. Like, that was low key an accident.
I
nigga,
can't believe I took credit for that shit like that. But fuck it, we here.
Everybody like, oh my god, great play. It's like you play. Listening to them. Like, yeah.
Yo,
yeah.
It'd be like a forced fumble. You was really just going for a nigga leg. But the nigga dropped that on some nut shit. Niggas coming to you. Yeah, nigga, you a savage, nigga. Yeah, nigga. Play Michael. That's you.
Play Michael.
That's crazy.
That's crazy.
That's crazy.
I'll be like, look, dog.
That's crazy, gang. That's crazy.
Nah, let me take you the credit, though.
You got to.
One day I'll be honest, nigga. I'll be like, nah, it was an accident. See what nigga says.
Nah, somebody, hey, bro, I ain't going to hold you. Somebody will probably try to flip it to you. Boy, you just that great. You that cold, man. You doing some accident? No, that's funny.
Nah, I ain't gonna hold you. So
that's funny as hell.
I was watching. I seen the sack, but I had seen the flag too. So even when he had the ball was fumbled, and I saw a buck went and grabbed it, I had knew it was a flag. And like he said, it was just like. But I was trying to. I was telling people about this too. I was just like, I felt like I got such a different perspective of like how we all gonna respond to that. So like speed, and I see speed. I see Speed not really celebrating, so I'm like, all right, damn, he kind of see what's going on. We got to wait. It's like a critical moment in the game. But for me, I feel like you know, I'm the play caller. And I actually talked to Gardner about this too. Like, sometimes it's just like, at that moment, we got to adjust to the new situation that's about to go on. So, like, regardless of whether that was a good call, bad call, it's fucked up, it's right, whatever it is.
Yeah, we got to make it.
Nigga, it's first and eight from the 8, 10 seconds left. We got to lock in right now. Let's move on. Like, I feel like I be trying to be that boy because I know how that is. Like, when you out there, like, even, like, Buck John. Buck is 6'7", bro. How the hell is he supposed to hit the strike zone on P.J. Walker? Like, and I love P.J. Shout out P.J., but he's like 5'11", bro. P.J. a Jersey legend. I ain't trying to gain Temple legend, but P.J. about 5'11", bro. Buck 6'7", rolling full speed. Of course, he's going to smother his ass. Buck pissed. I'm like, Buck, come on, we got to move on. You know what I'm saying? And it just be like, trying to get everybody back in a moment for what is necessary, but I mean, but I ain't gonna hold you, and I'll let you go real quick. But it devastated me that they stole that moment from Speed. That's just how I felt. Mm. Like I just knew, like it's like a lot of things. Like when you watching, you with somebody, y'all going through it, we grinding. That's your home. You rooting for him, and you be like, damn, I'm happy that he made that play. Like, damn, I know what that's gonna do for him. You know what I mean?
That's a career booster right there.
Yeah. Not even just that, just for your confidence. Yeah. Now you really about to be it. Now you strip sack ball. So now
you gonna
like,
go crazy.
Look, I tell people all the time, that shit like blood in the water. Mm-hmm. Like all the DBs, they get their first pick. After that, they just start jumping shit.
Hell yeah.
And you get that first kill, and it's just like, it's on. Like, you know what I'm saying? You finally felt what that type of success, that type of victory feel like. So I would say that was just like, that was my biggest takeaway from it. But I mean, at the end of the day, bro, my shit just be like, bro, like, right or wrong, no matter how much you cuss a referee out, they're not picking up that.
Yeah, they're not.
But not because of something you said.
Right.
So you telling him he a square ass, mark ass, he you a no good sucking jobbing. Yeah, pause.
All right.
My man's not picking the flag up. It's already out there, buddy.
I forgot someone to jump. But nah, that's not gonna make dog pick the flag up, bro. You know what I mean? But it is what it is. Like, you know what I mean? It was definitely a tough joint. That shit was heavy because I feel like even at the end of it, I felt like we were just like 6 inches too short, bro. Like, we was on that goal line. First of all, I don't know if anybody's seen the video. I'm really in the back of the video. The old lineman got me in a headlock with his leg wrapped around me. But I still had cream leg, though. I'm in that bitch like.
I'm gonna hold on, goddamn. That's crazy.
Hey, I ain't gonna hold. A nigga coming from the bottom of this shit, it feel good that the ref actually called me by my name now.
What you mean?
They call me EJ.
Oh, when they see you out there now?
Yeah.
They be like, hey, what's up, EJ?
They
told you watch the pod.
I don't know if they watch the pod or not, but they be like, hey, what's up, EJ?
Yeah, everybody trying to be nice.
Yeah,
they
be cool.
I respect it.
Maybe it's the Browns name. Maybe like the NFL reviewed it and shit. Because the NFL did review it and say it was actually... Hey. It wasn't a PI.
I just don't understand what's the big deal about that. Because are y'all gonna give us the win?
No,
what are we even really discussing at this point? That law's still gonna hit.
It's still there.
4 weeks from now, nobody gonna say, damn, you know the Colts lost. They're gonna say, no, the Colts lost to the Browns by 30, by 1 point. That's what they're gonna say. So it's just like, as I said, like all the semantics and that's how I feel about, that's how I try to like take it with flags. Like, you gotta see what happened, accept it, learn from it, like cycle of the play. And just try to keep going, because it's just like, bro, all right, look, you know what I'm saying, win or lose, right call or wrong call, look, you know what I'm saying, it's a lot of shit that happened in the game that we could have did what we should have did, but,
So how that next step, though, like, because obviously I'm glad you talked about that, like, having that, I'll call it mental toughness or mental fortitude for something like that that could have ended the game, like, completely, but then y'all got to go back out there, like, bro, we got to, it's really over, like, how... I don't know. I mean, I guess, like, is that something that you just kind of like, all right, bro, I just got to play and then go through it, or?
I mean, maybe it was the second flag.
Shit like, I'd do it again.
He said,
I'm a nut.
Maybe it was the one after that, and I'm like, all right, what are we doing?
It was a double. Like I said, I don't know. It just seemed like.
First of all,
I read something.
Hold on. We cannot talk about, what is that, week 6, week 7?
Yeah.
Blitz fit speed.
Hey, come on now. I be feeling like the man when I hey.
Y'all finna start playing with speed because he be putting that shit on. Tell him.
Niggas gotta know who I am.
Mister, put it on.
That's what I'm saying.
Shout out to.
Let me stop playing.
Shout out to speed, man. You know what I'm saying?
Put that homie on.
You already. Put that homie.
Turn him up, man.
First of all, I couldn't tell this nigga shit.
Not a damn thing.
He knew he put one of them joints on. Nigga came in the training room, bro. Walked right in.
That's walked in the training room.
He said, look. And y'all don't even peep. I could wear the vest
it's like
that.
That's what I said.
I said, no, Speed.
That's just not my bag, though.
Okay.
Plenty of niggas got it.
Niggas be showing off, bro. Speed, niggas be showing off.
When you got that shit on, you got to bust down the training room. You got to
do the lap, bro. You got to do the lap, bro. Speed probably walked out on the field and shit trying to see somebody.
I ain't even taking that far. I just walked through that joint. You could just tell how niggas was already gassing me.
Yeah.
Like, the whole coach staff, they in that motherfucker like.
So I did, hold on, wait, before I let Speed go real quick.
Please relax. I do. You just like Jayda.
You know, like, no.
I'm walking through that bitch like, I got that shit on, nigga.
He did. Because I gassed you too, because I was proud.
Nah, I gotta give major credit to the cameraman though, because everything just really like
Matt Bowen
the right way. Like everybody,
Shout out to Matt Bowen. Most of that stuff is the picture though.
Sometimes it just be the picture. If you get a good picture, that's what
I feel
what
like.
Really
BlitzFitz is a credible source
for sure.
Shout out BlitzFitz.
Oh my god.
Shout out BlitzFitz.
I'm the only one.
I'm just saying, I don't know who he is. This week, all weekend, I've been waiting on niggas to come outside. Speed out there with the ball, nigga, spilling water. Speed been in the locker room starting Clothes Wars.
Yeah.
Hey.
Beef with between the position rooms. It's like a March Madness not even it's like a Tekken, you know, when you him versus yeah. like to see what, yeah, it's
but
one of them
no,
type
think
joints.
About that though. That's not even a battle. Defense always come with the fits on the team.
They got the joints popping up to where they rating fits now.
Oh yeah, yeah, I did see that. Oh yeah, side by side.
Yeah, we do got to do that, John.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
look, he started matching up. They didn't start doing this until I put that shit on. I promise you. How you gonna match me up with Kenny? I'm like, bro, why you do that?
Oh,
you
match up with K-Mo?
That's his matchup, bro. Damn. That's his matchup.
Hey, bro, put that shit on, bro. Put that shit on, bro. No. I'm not gonna lie to you.
Correct.
That's really if you my man's. That's really like a 6-seed versus a 1. Like, that's Duke. That's a 6-1.
Kenny, I'm a 6-seed?
Bro, that's 6-seed. Nice.
No, he definitely won with Zion and R.J. Barrett. But damn, I got to be 6.
You Gonzaga, bro.
I'm going to keep it above.
Okay, no, don't do him 6.
I'm going to keep it above.
Gonzaga tough. Drew Timmy. Shout out my boy Drew Timmy, bro. Gonzaga tough.
A 6 is insane.
Z my mans and Kenny my man.
Do you be seeing the NCAA tournament bracket? It's 18 teams on one side.
Tim, you really feel like I can't.
No, it's not that, bro. I can't
let
you do my
dog.
Pause.
Tim, did you just ask me if I've seen an NCAA bracket?
Yes, have you seen it? It's 18 teams on one side. So to be number 6 and a verse of 1, that's
did
a good
Tim,
team.
Did Tim just ask me?
Clean it up.
Yeah, try again. Because you're going to piss me off.
Have you ever seen that?
Have I ever seen a
college basketball team, bro?
And this isn't my first.
So when I say a 1 versus 6, you should understand that that is a good matchup. What are we talking about?
First of all, I don't like that this
conversation. We're talking about
one.
It's that's
Speed
a
versus
but you're
Kenny.
Talking about him
a
being a 6.
Yes.
Bro, look. Bro, this is what I'm saying.
50 other niggas on the team.
Look, you're not low. Honestly, though, Tim, look.
That's low for all these niggas.
If Z and Kenny
okay.
matched up for 6 weeks,
okay,
Z Oof. Coming out with 2 weeks.
First of all,
on the street apparel.
Hold the fuck on.
Kenny is a heavy stepper.
Hold the fuck on.
Kenny a heavy stepper. Is he coming out 2 weeks?
Kenny
will win for.
Kenny will win
for.
I see how y'all want me to
I ain't say that, bro.
First of all, don't do that. Me and Kenny are from different places. We are different.
That's the point.
So hold on. So understand something.
Kenny reach long, nigga.
How I carry and how I move is off of me. So we ain't.
That's a fact.
We ain't doing that.
That's a fact.
We ain't. Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? How Kenny carried, Kenny got his type style. Like, that's who Kenny is. First of all, if you haven't met Kenny, Kenny is constantly working on shit, fixing the shit. This nigga always getting work done at the house, bro. For sure. This nigga got multiple houses, and they always getting work done.
For sure.
Motherfucker is just the interior designer. He wanted them. You know what I'm saying? So like,
he's very much a smart.
He got a lot of shit going on over there. Look, I ain't, leave me out of that shit. We talking about Speed. First of all, I made Bliss Fist before Speed. We got, okay. I've been on there a couple times.
We're talking on the archives.
We're talking about this season.
Oh, my God. Ask him what happened this week, though.
This week? I can't hear him.
He walked in the training room. He didn't even walk in the training room.
You can't do that. And then,
niggas know my rules.
What I say, it's a week to week league.
You got to. Hold on, Speed.
Niggas know my rules, bro. My rules is when the season is going well, we snapping or whatever like that, then I'll put it on.
This nigga got.
Yeah, niggas
rules,
hate when I say that. Niggas hate when I say that. But look, when shit ain't going how I feel like shit should be going,
yeah.
I'm on business. I throw on a hoodie, cargos, da da da. But it was still fresh, though. It was the Heron Preston setup.
Okay.
I had the Heron Preston undershirt. I had the Heron Preston turtleneck with the Heron Preston hoodie.
Okay.
I had the chrome.
So hold on. Okay. Rank the seating that we had for the DB room in terms of who was best dressed, the worst dressed. Because I feel like that would give more clarity to the conversation that we was having.
In the DB room, it was Kenny at 1. I believe it was Dallo at 2.
You said Dallo at 2?
I think it was Dallo at 2. In
okay,
the DB room.
I just want to clarify for Dallo. Shout out young Dallo.
In the DB room, Dallo was at 2. Who was at 3? Was it in the DB room, period?
I would say Julian,
Black, and then I would say DJ.
You said DJ?
DJ put some shit on, bro. He be chilling when he wore the. You gotta go check him out. He be sneaking some shit in there, and niggas be sleep on DJ though.
You don't like Jay Jones?
Nah, Juju Brents before DJ.
Oh, yeah.
Juju exactly.
Brents. Juju Brents. Okay. Juju Brents. It's kind of debatable between him and Black.
Damn. So rank the linebacker room.
Shit, I go you first. DME, D Leonard, Shay.
That's humble.
Shay.
You're a humble guy, Jay.
Yeah.
I respect that about you.
Yo, you've been throwing real darts at me.
How, bro?
That's crazy.
I'm just saying. It's a problem. I just think it's so crazy that's how you're not going to turn up on Tim real quick.
You being real spicy
what
over this
mean?
Way.
What you
mean?
That's humble, bro.
Y'all okay. Like, so you Tim say whatever.
So what was the worst fit I had this year?
The worst fit you had this year?
I just want to know. This year.
Let me get on Instagram.
Not gonna lie to you. Nah, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna do it on camera, bro. I am not doing on camera.
Tim, you've already been petty. I think it's all right.
I'm not, you don't not like, being you petty. Don't like I'm just stating
it,
just the facts.
Damn, what's the worst one? That's cool.
The worst fit.
It's closed. It ain't like we talking about.
I think it was actually the Cleveland Browns. I think it was the top that you had, the camo top.
Oh, yeah. That was the
gallery dip.
Yeah, that was the gallery dip. That's
but actually he was on. You was on the twist thing because TB was saying we was going. The whole twist was TB was saying we was going army fatigue.
Okay, I didn't obviously. Back. I don't know the.
So that was kind of a skewed fit, but yeah. I mean, that was I put
what
it
was,
on.
What was wrong with the fit?
I just didn't like it. Compared to this week. Like this week, I thought you had a fire fit on.
Let me say this too, because I actually wanted to point this out. I feel like people really underestimate how little you have those clothes on. Like you literally put them clothes on in the morning. You wear that shit to a place and then change
take
out
that
of
shit
some,
off.
Right like right yeah. off. So like on game day, you know, I literally wake minutes. Up, eat breakfast in that shit, walk in the stadium, and then take it off. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I mean, obviously you wear
literally
it home.
Put that shit on for to walk 100 feet.
Yeah, and also
you put it on for the ground for sure.
But see, but this also like where I see that too. Like I feel like there's a difference between something that's fashionable or something that's hard to wear to a game and then something that's hard that you would just wear out. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, okay. The shit that I had on, I slid out in. Okay. Same fit, no nothing. I just pulled up on that. You niggas be having some hard fits with the Prada hard bottoms on, but they not finna move around in that.
Ew,
that's
no.
true.
You know what I'm saying? That's like,
true.
Every game ain't
picture.
Necessary. Like you said, then also we was going on some camo shit. I had the gallery pullover. I was just gonna pull over. Hey, not that I'm really explaining my fit to you because it's not that deep. But what I'm going to say, I'm like, damn, like.
I appreciate
niggas
you.
Said the, niggas in the gallery. Niggas said the gallery pullover was corny. Like,
niggas said you were a six. I'm just like.
He said I'm a six.
On the whole
like,
team
yeah,
a six?
I,
bro.
I'm sad, though.
Yo, man. Y'all don't watch nothing on the it's NCAA okay. tournament. Y'all it's don't okay. watch any of that, bro.
It's okay.
I get it, bro.
Moving on to New Orleans. New Orleans, man. Yeah, just coming into the week. I'm trying to say, Coming into the week, we had a knowing we had a good opponent coming in, trying to get that joint again back at home, man. It's been tough, but you know, we're gonna keep it rolling, man. It wasn't our best game, to be honest with you, especially as a defense, man. Mm-hmm. And I just say that's a frustrating feeling to have, bro. Like,
I guess just for both of y'all, like, think of it this way, or just like a question from the other side. You know, y'all are a defense that's like pretty much put together for the most part. Like, you know, like, and y'all been like, okay, like, how is it like when you had in pits? Like, people don't think like shit. I mean, y'all. Like, y'all humans, you know what I'm saying? Like, you
to go through a slump or something. Yeah. Like that. I wouldn't even say it's that. It just, I don't know. Like, it's like everything else. Like I said before about the looking back on the call with the Browns. Like, when you look back on it, you don't say, oh, they lost the game because of that. You just say, oh, they lost. You move on. Like, you don't look back and say, oh, like, you know, they scored this many points because of whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, so at the end of the day, it's like what you put on tape and what the numbers reflect is your legacy, honestly. So it's like you got to continue to work on that. But that's why it's just kind of like we just got to, I mean, take every 1 week at a time. But it's just really just getting back to being you, you know what I'm saying? Playing, you know what I'm saying? Getting back to the basics type shit like that. But like I said, shout out to the Saints, man. You know, they definitely had a jump. First of all, I got to say this about Taysom Hill, bro. Taysom Hill, my high school quarterback was just like Taysom Hill, bro.
Really?
Yeah, he the white boy that you play, and you like, man, he a good player, but you
feel he ain't crazy.
But then after you play him, you like, you know what, that guy's a pretty good, he's a pretty good football player.
Nose is excellent enough.
Even though I will say, that boy got off. I'm like, damn, this nigga actually.
He actually crazy.
He not little. Okay, what I will say, though, is Taysom Hill is a Karen, though, and I really didn't appreciate that.
Damn. Whoa.
He's a Karen, bro.
Whoa.
Bro, so I don't know if you've seen it on the film. So they got the goal line. We in the goal line. We warring and shit. It's like third and goal and some shit, whatever. He get into it with TB, whatever. They call it the personal foul. What happened, though, him and TB got a little back and forth. TB go. Then he go to the ref. Ref, what, you see him?
Oh, my God.
No.
Ref throw the flag.
I know he's lying.
I said Taysom.
And he throwing it for Taysom.
Yeah, he throwing it.
Oh, yeah?
He throwing the flag for Taysom, I guarantee
you. I was really wondering how did it even happen though in the game? Like, it didn't even seem like it was in the floor.
Bro, he literally, like, tattletaled on the field. I'm like, yeah, that's game.
So he threw a temper tantrum and got the flag.
That's crazy. Hey, man, look,
I need to see this.
Smoke, I definitely need, see that shit up close. How was the spin versus Kamara? Like, y'all was out there with some hitters out there yesterday.
First of all, that nigga grill really buzzed down out there. Yeah. That shit actually crazy as fuck to see.
I ain't gonna hold, bro. Bro was like, hey, he dabbed me, like, coming on a field or whatever like that. He's like, yo, speed, woo, woo. I was like, the nigga grill had, like, you feel what I'm saying? I was like, yeah, bro, keep shining. And I'm like...
Hey, speed, that bitch was glistening in your eye.
I had to catch myself, like... I hope this nigga knew I meant, like, nigga. Keep having a good career, nigga. Fuck you mean, nigga. Nigga, the roof closed,
keep
the lights
in. Yo, keep shining.
Keep shining.
But you know,
I thought you was about to say he was blinding you with his teeth.
I hope this nigga know, nigga.
That shit crazy,
bro.
I'm like, that.
Wait, is this mouthpiece or is
he got
teeth?
The bust down 32 that he out there playing with the.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought,
And whatever, wow. Whatever jeweler did that motherfucker, hey.
Them bitches look heavy. It looks heavy.
That's crazy.
Then he bring the chain out the pads.
For sure.
And he wear the chain out too.
He been having his chain on too.
Yeah, I wore my chain too.
I did see that.
Mm. But how you gonna feel?
You didn't see me wear my shit during. You see me wear my shit during the game?
Shit got yanked.
You had it on again?
Yeah.
I knew you had it on all week though.
Yeah.
He definitely had it on the game. I be asking to practice what I'm wearing in the game. Like, let's say like.
Got to. Dead ass.
Let's say I'm going to wear sleeves in the game. I got to wear sleeves in practice. Like, this got to be an all week thing.
Wait, like a single sleeve or like the long
anything,
sleeve shirt?
Okay. Anything, nigga, that you see me on in the game, I wore that all week at practice.
Speed been double sleeve from the cleats, lately, though.
From the cleats to the gloves to everything.
You a double sleeve?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm double sleeve now.
I've been fucking with the double sleeve.
For real?
Yeah, I've been fucking
with it too.
Great job.
That's straight. That's crazy. Oh, Super Sidewalk. Definitely got to give y'all some credit. Y'all did come out and swag the Indy Knights. Y'all did y'all think with that jump? The uniforms.
Yeah.
Y'all went crazy.
Those were lit.
Y'all went crazy.
And people have been begging for a helmet, so I hope they're glad.
Yeah.
Helmet.
Nah, for sure. Yo, you know, you see me got the joint up there. Yeah. That black boy crazy.
Yeah, no, that shit is lit.
That with the black face, man, that shit made me want to put, like, when I was in Little League, we had Black Humming. I put the blue tape around the bars.
What you know about that?
If you really was a stepper, you did
Yeah,
shit.
You know exactly.
Like, you know what I'm saying? If you wasn't really spending, you know
take some time to do that shit, too.
Nah, for sure. You Arthur, you can't wait to pull up the practice. Y'all
had the stickers?
Fresh?
Sitting at the kitchen table. Is.
Yeah.
A couple different pounds did it, but yeah, we had the stickers. You had the stickers?
Yeah, what was y'all shit? Was it like big hits, big plays? It was like you get the skull crusher for big hits.
Yeah.
You get the star for like a big play.
Mm-hmm.
It was like different. It was different logos for different
yeah,
shit.
Like, yeah, like sack, big play, you know, good performance. Yeah. I feel like I just remember all of us just doing the same job, but definitely got the
whole cold nigga up. Have all the stickers.
Yeah, all the stickers on there.
Niggas used to steal stickers and shit.
That's so lame.
That was corny though. I do know
I niggas. Stealing just being
niggas. Niggas used to do it. Nah, I ain't steal my stickers, nigga. My stickers was legit.
I earned them stripes.
Yeah, nah, man, but I ain't gonna hold you. That black greasy, though. I ain't gonna hold you. We need to go to black on black, though, bro.
Now, that would be
That'd
lit.
That'd be crazy.
Bro. Ooh, especially whenever they turn the lights off. Ooh, y'all run out of the sun on that blue lights and the smoke.
Look,
this
the
should be
black, with the matte black helmet.
They ain't doing
saucy.
That shit, though.
I'm getting greasy, y'all. I don't know.
Yeah, no, that joint was tough.
That speed teller had a metallic blue face mask and shit.
Everything. You feel me? And then he started Blitz Fits for Field swag, nigga.
Oh my god.
They have one.
I be
they
do?
Yeah, it's called uniform swag.
Uniform swag?
Oh, okay.
It's they be having like the cleats and all that shit. That's not you ain't.
They gotta holler at me. Cause I do be out there.
No, okay. But can we go
I'm
back?
Double sleeve.
He really out here with at this Blitz Fist done went to this man's
I
head.
I told y'all.
Oh,
I told this is what
and
I've been
I
telling
was really gassing him. I was on Instagram like, damn, I know that's right. And this man is tripping.
I just wish I seen niggas.
Oh
like, you
my
know
god,
what
this man right here is talking about.
I just wish I seen.
Y'all see
come
my,
outside.
Y'all see
came outside.
They done made this man post a whole Instagram picture. Speed don't post shit on Instagram. Now he want
to
post.
You just see how you stepping. It's a road game coming up. Can we expect another Blitz Fist performance?
We can.
What color are you going to wear?
If the people need me, hey, if the people tell me, Speed, you know, do what you do, be you, I'm going to come out.
Bro, stop.
Who are you?
We're done.
I love that, bro.
I do got to speak on this from New Orleans, bro. So many of everybody have seen, you know, last year when we did the joint practice with the Lions, me and... Jamal Williams got into it. Now, let me just say this, because I am frequent in getting in practice beef. So let me just say, speak on that. It was just kind of one of them situations. After it was done, he tried to holler at me afterwards, but I felt like during practice, we didn't get a chance to really go one-on-one. So I was just like, okay, come on, I need to, you feel me? We gotta really see this through. If you beefing with somebody at the beginning, that's a lifetime battle, you know what I'm saying?
Sure.
But I'm sure it's whatever. So he in New Orleans. I'm out there ready for war. Like, first of all, I could tell that he was trying to gauge my temperature because he walked by us when we doing our warm-up. I don't know if y'all be seeing me and Speed be warming up together before the game. Mm-hmm. So we doing our warm-up, and we go out there early. Like, when we go out there, like, other teams, like, a couple of their players just be about to trickle out. We be out there early. I see him trying to walk by. He see us. I see if he trying to get the eye, like, we about to...
Wait.
Nah, nigga.
He shot.
It's Oppie.
Nah. Look, no.
Because he had a lot to do.
Man. Oh, my goodness.
This motherfucker. Ooh, he ended the beef, and I hate it.
Damn.
He ended it, and I hate it. I'm on that. I'm trying to press his ass during the game and all that. He trying to be cool and shit. Now I'm feeling bad and shit. I'm like, damn.
Now you a bully.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Now you bullying this man.
I'm out here, you know, talking about Naruto. I ain't never even, I, like.
Oh, my God.
I'm out here drunk. Like, I'm out here on some neck ass shit. He told me he fucking with me. So, like, yeah, look, man, it's over with, man.
You want to keep sometimes keep
but
the
But you know what?
There
was some spicy
going.
Beef during. So that lit. Shit was funny during practice, though.
Oh, what? When we
Yeah, no. Because I was on the sideline, like, these niggas, this shit funny as hell. Like, these cameras out here.
That's crazy.
No, that Hard Knock shit.
That shit
crazy,
was like though. A reality TV show. I'm like, we really out here with these cameras like this. Like,
like Jocelyn and I be telling
you
about the hip hop.
You trying to get out of the camera.
You.
I'm like, bro,
the crazy
shit
part
is
about
really
that situation
like,
right
now.
You got to find you a nigga to beef with now. Like,
hell yeah. It's like, folks, you be practice. Waiting for it. Like, how you not?
Like,
what's the storyline?
They beefing and like, when they start beefing and then shit get physical. It's like the group of linebackers come, then they group of running backs come.
Mm-hmm. And that shit make for
Swift's
a good
my
ass
man,
episode.
So I know I can't go at Swift. So now I gotta pick another nigga, like.
Swift makes me have every beef too. Why Swift keep getting caught in the crossfire of all the shit? Bro.
Swift be in a way, right? He's mad, not problematic too.
Like Swift, not Swift even like that. Swift be out there chilling though. I was kicking it with Kamara though, which was crazy because I was cool with Kamara, but I was beefing with Jamal, so it was like opposite. I had to check every play. Who in there? All right, back cool. Don't worry about
it. It's cool. It's cool over there today. Right now.
Yeah, but nah, man. That's tough. That, the game was crazy, man. You know, coming in and out, just trying to battle. Again, man, just you know, just trying to keep going. But it's some crazy shit going on in the football world right now, bro. Can we please get into Michigan, bro? Like that shit actually been bothering me a little bit, man. No, yeah. Nobody take that bait.
I mean, I think you gotta. My take on it is that Harbaugh like. Has taken it to another level. I feel like it's the difference between like scouting, looking at tape, and like knowing we talked about it, and like knowing what another team is going to do because you're preparing. But it goes to another level for me when I'm able to know exactly what a call may be or what something may be, and I got it in front of me. And now you're about to go run this play with 3 minutes left in the game to go get a first down, and I'm like, hold time out. They about to do X, Y, Z out there right now. Go ahead and make the play. Because I wrote it down. I know exactly what the fuck you about to do. So I feel like that's, at that point, and I know we were talking, bro, we actually, me and Z, we talked about this a little bit offline. Like, that to me is stripping away, like, the, really, like, the X's and O's and the essence of football when you do that. Because at that moment, you ain't playing football. I was like, hold on, you about to do what? Hold on, let me go ahead and change this. All right, go ahead and do what you're going to do because you're going to get it wrong anyway because I got your answers. So I think it's something to be said. And I think, like I said, I think Michigan at the beginning of the year, just as the, you know, kudos to their AD and stuff like that, they did a school ban. Like they did their own thing before the NCAA did something. So those three games that he got suspended before was just from the institution. But now I think something's going to happen with obviously the NCAA and everything that's going on.
Oh, yeah, he was suspended before that, huh?
Yeah, it was the school.
Oh, for recruiting.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, that boy been getting off.
It was the school.
Yeah, he been getting off.
It was bad. So, it's crazy. But I agree. Like I said, I agree with you, though, Z. Like, it's crazy, bro. Like, it's wild.
What's your next speed?
I mean, shit.
It is what it is.
If that's my coach, shit, is we winning?
Yo, that's crazy.
Not bad, T. Did call.
That shit look
that's
good.
Crazy.
My only thing, ain't no rat now.
My only thing is everybody steals signals though, bro.
Yeah.
Like my thing is, I just feel like when you playing in any game, whether it's baseball, you know, football, anything, even you know, a point guard running and calling a play, if your signals are simple enough and dumb enough that everybody can figure that shit out, then guess what? Shame on you.
Right. We all know about this.
Yeah, you outside, nigga. We all know about you. You nasty and everybody got your work. You know what I mean? That's just how it is. I just say that, you know, coming with a sheet of paper with the signals on it prior to the game, that's a little greasy, gang. That's all I'm going to say.
That's right. Like you were saying
that's
that
a little premeditated. You feel me? I don't know if that's manslaughter. you know what I'm saying? But no, that shit crazy though. But we jumping all over the place. What you think about Olympic roster? We gotta wait till we got Isaiah over here.
Please, oh my gosh. I've been waiting to ask y'all about this. First of all, I don't know if y'all would be able to break that down, but I don't know if it's like an offense, defense kind of thing, or if everybody gotta play on both sides of the ball, but it would really be a tough team to like make if the NFL players did the USA football. Like that would be crazy. Like
I really think it's like some niggas that actually play flag football, like that in real life. In real life, they be cooking at that shit. Cause Isaiah Rodgers, he like in a flag. He got flag football shit.
For sure,
like his partners and shit.
I know somebody on that Olympic team though.
Oh wow!
I know their best receiver. Shout out Bruce Matt. I can always tell you about him.
That's crazy.
Yeah, no,
be surprised if it's only like 2-3 NFL niggas on that motherfucker.
Niggas
be getting off, bro. Wow. If you ever see that little shit on Instagram, I think it's like 7-on-7 something.
Yeah.
But them motherfuckers
they do be going crazy, though.
All right, but hold on.
I'll cook one of them.
Jalen Ramsey over here.
Mm-hmm.
We got Surtain over here.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, bro. Yeah. Tyreek here. Justin Jefferson right here.
Right.
Kelsey somewhere in the middle over here.
Either Patrick Mahomes or whoever.
I'm looking quarterback. For quarterback. I know it's going to kill me, but I would low-key go Herbert. Just hear me out. Okay. I'm not saying it. Obviously, Patty number one. But I just feel like Herbert, when I played Herbert gave me that we in L.A., this the elite 11-7. Yeah, he okay. Couldn't just go out there. Just, you okay. Know what I'm saying? No pad rush. He just out there being light, and she looked like one of them fucking niggas that's still in the elite.
But they went, so am I, so speed.
It got to be Lamar for sure.
That's why, bro, I'm like, dog, because you can rush.
You can rush.
You can rush.
Oh,
you can rush.
Yeah, they can rush.
Shit like 7-on-7.
No.
Yeah. Oh, this flag.
Yeah. This flag, like.
Oh, yeah.
They rush.
They got a line. God. Some flag teams got a line.
Oh, yeah. You
do. Some flag teams actually got an offensive defensive line. Mm. That's why I said, like, bro, that's a tough squad.
What O-lineman are you picking on that, Joe?
O-lineman?
Mm.
Trent?
Number one.
Big Trent?
Man, Trent gonna fight somebody out there, bro.
That's what you...
Yep.
That's what I mean.
Gonna pick a little Belgian.
Just throw him. I don't even know what O-lineman I'll pick. That's cheat. Hard, but 7-on-7?
Gotta get Mark Andrews or some shit. Just and lie to shit. The Europeans. Bro. Like, nah, this nigga play O-line.
Yeah, he play O-line. Yeah.
that squad, though, if the NFL did do that, though, that squad would be so crazy, bro.
You know, everybody really been killing it. Everybody really do want to hear our top five white boys. I ain't going to hold you. I'm actually cool with my list, but I don't know. Like, everybody really been honest about that, John, too. Everybody been really wanting to know.
Everybody got to drop a list?
Do you have a five?
I do have my five.
Tim, go first.
Wow, I was going first on the five. All right. I know I shot him some hate, but he's number one on my list. Travis Kelce is number one
so
on my
Kelce
list.
Kelce one?
Kelce's one on my list.
Okay.
We're not doing mix. So like,
I ain't going to hold y'all damn near claim Kelce for Kelce. Us. I ain't going to cap. Even though I know he's switching back, but it's cool. Don't worry about
I'm going Kelce one. Watt two.
TJ?
Which yes.
one?
Okay, TJ. TJ, of course. Two. Three on my list was... Ooh. Who was three on my list? Hold on.
Speed.
Handy-dandy notebook.
Speed.
How you not say...
I'm going to go Kittle.
I'm trying to make sure I get y'all my list.
No specific order.
Okay.
Kittle.
Yeah.
Harrison Smith.
I like Harrison.
Harrison
I like
Smith. Harrison. That's legendary.
That nigga be on the line of scrimmage.
On me.
Playing cover two safety. Go book it. Fit the A-gap.
On me.
Harrison like that.
Christian.
McCaffrey.
Yeah. Definitely up there.
Indeed.
McCaffrey. Who else? Get over Dawson Knox nice too.
Dawson Knox, the tight end?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
He nice.
That's interesting. And, I always be wondering the type of tight ends that you like. You do like that type of tight end, though. That's your run stop and shit.
Then who else? I got one more, huh?
Yeah.
Five Joey.
Is hard.
Joey Bosa. Yeah.
Joey? Okay. Jayda?
Mm. Oh.
Jayda, do you have a five?
Yeah. TJ Watt, Kittle, Travis Kelce, and Christian McCaffrey. I guess I don't have five. I just have four.
That's crazy. I'm going to just be honest. This whole conversation, whole thought started because I was watching Max Crosby, and I'm like, this nigga is crazy.
Nah, he is crazy. Max Crosby is crazy.
I'm watching Max Crosby like, bro, like, who the fuck? This nigga different.
Yeah.
Been in yadded up.
Yeah.
Let me chill. Shout out to him.
But hold on. Cooper did make my list.
Cooper definitely did make my list.
It literally looked like it hurt to block Max Crosby, bro.
Bro, nigga got crazy ass effort too. Motherfucker just really the type you knock. He like the boy you really beat up four times, keep getting up. You be like,
he remind me of like
so
Tyson Fury or some shit.
Like, oh wow.
That's his comparison. Wow. This motherfucker like.
He just start bugging out. Like you watch like and maybe it's because obviously Gus came from Vegas, so we watched a ton of Vegas films.
Okay.
Man, but it was just like, you know, we watching this motherfucker just jumping off the tape. You know what I'm saying? Mm. So definitely Max. I mean, we practice against McCaffrey. We practice and played against McCaffrey.
True.
And I'm telling you, it was in the middle of August. I'm like, whoever's doing this nigga massages, activation, there's no way this nigga should be punching the ground like that.
Like, what is going like, huh?
I'm like, all right, this motherfucker. Tripping. That boy said, bro, I feel like Christian McCaffrey like a grown Cody Paul. Like, he who we thought
that's
he
exactly
was always,
remind me of.
We thought he was who he always going to grow up to be. Now it's McCaffrey as this motherfucker run perfect.
Yeah, that's true. And he is cold, though. Like, actually watching him practice, he like that.
I like Cup, too. Cup crazy.
Wait, can I add? I mean, I feel like I understand that they may not be at the front of the league right now, but I feel like if I don't throw Joe Burrow in my top five.
Oh, non-QB. Non-QBs?
Okay.
QBs get too much love anyway, man.
That's me, though. Like, I feel like you just looking at the whole league, offense, defense, like, I got it, though.
Joe Burrow?
For me, my five.
Yeah.
But I understand, though. It is something good to actually, like, you know, to be on, kind of talking about with that.
Hey, man, Speed, we got that Germany trip coming up soon, bro.
Definitely. I'm going to learn me some little German before I go.
Y'all excited to eat?
I'm nervous.
See what?
Sausages.
Did
I walk into that?
That's a bad joke.
Did I walk into that? What the fuck?
But I ain't going to hold you. Not on no kink shit, though. Like, that's like one of their, like, delectables.
That's
their
thing.
That's their
sausages
thing.
Sausages
like
and,
I thought it was like
onions, word.
Onions.
You about to go over there and get some wieners, bro.
It's stew.
Wieners and onions.
That's crazy.
It's stew, ain't it?
Nah, it's the...
I'm confused.
The no, joke. They're like big-ass sausage.
See,
wildin'.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Nah. I'm going to be honest. Fresh off the plane, too.
I'm a traveling...
Put down a Celsius.
For facts.
I'm a traveling bull, but I am a little nervous to go somewhere where, like, ain't nobody speaking English. That shit make me, like, hold on, gang. Like,
I'm telling y'all, y'all going to get back and be confused when folks start speaking English. That's how I was when we came back from out the country. I was like, damn, I can understand everybody. This shit weird.
So America's stupid.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
Shit.
Don't care. Stay my ass right here.
Niggas wouldn't tell us they signing that check. I'm good. Yeah, niggas stay that way.
Stay my ass right here.
Stay that way.
This is actually my first time going out of the country.
Really?
Like, why hold my passport hostage too? I gotta talk to them.
No, I really don't like that. They done had our passport for about like 2 months. I'm using everything I can. I'm one of them people. I'm like, no, I'm gonna just keep it. They took my joint now. I feel naked without that joint. I feel like I can't. Like, what if I gotta get out of here in the middle of the night? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I don't know what I got going on, nigga.
Yeah, they don't know what I'm trying to get done. Like, you know what I'm saying?
And where you got it? Is it like in the building? Like, all our shit just.
Bro, I ain't gonna lie. If you don't get every person's on this team passport or every man roster on this passport a month before, niggas will forget. Motherfuckers won't have one. That's find out. Week of the game. And Quentin ain't got no fucking passport. How the fuck?
Now you signed.
Quentin, what? You ain't got no passport, dog?
That's crazy. Now you got to go.
And this, bro, I ain't going to hold you. That be fucking like professional athletes up the most. Like, you be thinking, you just so used to the world catering to you until that shit about the government. The government. Hold on, gang.
I don't care about none of that.
It's going to take 6 to 10 business days to do this. You have to process this. Yeah, bro, but I'm trying to. Excuse me, you know what? 12 to 18.
You still feel like they got you fucked up. Like, nah, bro, I can call somebody.
No.
Come on, call the coach.
Actually, sir.
I'm about to call the coach.
Come on, call the coach.
Not playing with your ass.
Nah. Hey. They're going to give you an extra 2 days if you call them. Nah, we can't do that for you.
I really
want
to talk about bro got pulled over.
Oh, my God.
What happened?
His lineup was so trash, how he lined it.
All right, so everybody that don't know. I actually meant to say some shit about this damn game. This is how crazy I am. Chris Olave got pulled over driving in Louisiana. They arrested him for, I think he was 30 over speed.
Mm-hmm.
Which is not that bad, by the way.
Well, it's just, it was in a residential place. I think it would be hard for the people to understand. Like, we not from some of these places. So, like, it'd be hard for us to tell a little bit, like, what's a residential part and what's, like, part of the, I don't know, every city and different
connected
places
to
different.
A main street.
You're a rookie too. You don't understand. And I ain't gonna cap. When you in the Lamb Chop or the Hellcat, you just gotta tap that motherfucker. That
yeah,
you
know what I mean? That's
20 up already.
I'm saying that shit just get get up and get going. Shit like Z4.
Yo.
Ain't nobody buying that. You know, I'm about to start singing my own praises. Y'all gonna stop being in this.
Nah,
like,
bro.
Y'all better stop trying me.
They
like
said
that,
you
man.
Was a heat seeking
missile.
Don't worry
about it. We got Rod in the building. Rod, we dropping another tape on these niggas, man. Bro, I'm about to drop a flex bomb in this bitch. Y'all trying me in this motherfucker. But no, so like he gets pulled over. He gets arrested. I'm talking about young boy got the cuss behind his hand. Officer putting in the paper where he told myself. Yeah, but I play for the Saints. No, I ain't gonna hold you. I'm like, that. First of all, that was a Hail Mary throw.
Oh,
like, nigga, that was, I'm talking about minus 10. Like, yeah, you always backed up, dog. You threw that bitch to the 50, hoping for the tip, break a tackle, and then run another 50 yard. Like, bro, yeah, it's, that shit way too late for that gang. Too. I ain't even gonna hold you.
You in the cuffs and you drop
that? Yeah, that's a bad job.
When a good time to drop it, though? When a good time to drop it? Because every nigga, if you don't use that, nigga, you wanted the ticket. You wanted
I mean, it's all about how you get a presentation. You just gotta work it early into the combo. Yeah, man, you know it's Wednesday. I just got a game on Sunday against the Ravens. Oh, what do I do? Oh, yeah.
What do I do? What do I do?
You know what I mean?
It's like, funny you ask.
You handed a license. Zaire? Yeah,
oh,
Zaire.
Oh, number 40.
How you doing? Yes, sir, for the shoe.
I'm so sorry, you know.
On me. Uh-huh. Yes, sir. Zionsville Eagles. Yes, sir. Let's go. Let's get
him. Oh, man.
Yeah, you know what I mean? You nice as shit.
I feel like you really got to immediately slide that shit in.
You got to,
because my daddy used to be on that shit. Like, you know, the fire department. Oh, I didn't know you was a... Oh, go ahead, y'all. Go ahead.
Because I'm going my way to my auntie's, because she's a police officer for 25 years. Yeah, district. Yeah, okay. Yeah. I mean, you trying to...
I know, Carol. You know what I mean?
You trying to get out of that shit. Niggas don't... But it's just so nasty, Hunter Joe. But I'm going to be honest with you. The worst part of the whole video is, bro, you know what the officer said? Officer say, and?
Basically, like, but who are you?
First of all, that's an extremely unnecessary amount of hate. Like, oh, my crazy. God. Like, the and was like, oh, you used to play football, huh? Okay.
All right.
Okay, you a Michigan fan? Okay, cool. I dig it. You know what I'm saying? This some Ohio State Michigan shit like
that. Hang on, I would have said green ass nigga out of my brother. You green and fuck.
His feet is going to be
they don't know, know who I am.
You're going to beat your ass. Don't you forgetting. You're the middle of Louisiana. Stop playing like that.
Oh, me, low key.
Yo, right on it.
Low key.
Bro, I'm talking about my heart would have dropped. I tell the officer I play for the Colts and he say, and... Oh, damn, I'm going to jail.
Damn.
Yo, rap,
he is about
crazy,
the bookie, boy, if he don't care at all.
Like, man, it's outlandish amount of hate. Like, you like...
But hold on. Then I got... Hold on, wait, because now I really got to ask, though.
But like, you don't really say you stopped, pay for the coast. You just bust down a lot. You be like, damn, my bad, man. I'm on my way to meetings. I'm late as a motherfucker. They be fining us for it and all type of stuff. Yeah, man, we just got done playing. No, he watched the game.
For sure. That's what I was about to ask. Like, dang, is it wrong for them to be like, yeah, well, you played with the coach. Y'all lost me on that FanDuel shit last night. I'm about to write you this ticket.
Yeah, shit begins.
I'm about to write you this
shit
ticket.
But to just say I play for the Saints.
It's wild.
You setting yourself up for an and, nigga. Nigga gonna definitely hit you with the and if you just say I play for the Saints.
Yeah, but to say and is just like, oh my God. But they just aren't, bro, like you taking me to... I'm about to come right out, but you about to just put me all on ESPN. You about to fuck up all kind of shit. But I get it. 30 over is 30 over. So
yeah.
About to speed.
That's the thing.
Yeah, but yeah, look, man, thank you again for coming to another episode of The Trenches. You know, we back. Look, I know I've been listening to all the comments and everything. Mm-hmm. Everybody grinding said they want to speak on stuff. Look, we back to the weekly from this moment forward.
Yeah.
We be dropping weekly, recording weekly. So we'll definitely be up to date, man.
Yeah.
Like I said, I appreciate you guys tuning in. See you next week. Peace.
Peace.